Top line is a form of songwriting in which the vocal melody and lyrics are written to an existing music track. Top-lined songs generally sound like other songs, and they share a similar song structure. But the process of creating them is a little bit different. Normally, the vocal melody and lyrics are written first, then an arrangement is created to accompany them. But in Topline, things happen in reverse. A music producer, DJ, or production team creates the music track first. Then the topliner adds a vocal melody and lyric to the track. Because the melody isn't written until after the music track is recorded, the track usually features a generic, repetitive chord progression. Toplining originated in the electronic dance music genre, or EDM. Instrumental music dominated the dance clubs. Adding a vocal hook that could be sampled and repeated was icing on the cake. Eventually, these short vocal hooks expanded to become catchy, repetitive refrains and choruses. Fully developed, radio-friendly hit songs weren't far behind. Top-line track structure. When writing top-line, the first thing you'll do is listen to the instrumental track to find the important signposts that identify the track structure. This will help you find your way when you're writing your verses and choruses. The break. In all dance genres, the break or breakdown is an instrumental or percussion section in which the basic foundational rhythm, usually played by the bass and kick drum, is stopped, suspending the anchoring beat of the song and creating an interruption in the steady flow of the song's energy. The break tends to create tension as listeners wait for the expected basic beat to be reestablished. A break and buildup occurs when the foundational dance rhythm is faded down or muted, leaving some of the percussion or synth instruments to maintain the steady momentum. The track builds up tension with rising synth lines, filters, and added instruments in the upper registers. The drop, or bass drop. During the break and buildup, the tension rises until finally the kick drum and bass drop in at full volume, playing the dance beat. A drop is the point in a dance track when tension created by a break and buildup is released. In radio-friendly pop dance songs, this is sometimes referred to as the pop drop. Here's a great example of a break, buildup, and drop in the EDM hit Titanium by David Guetta with Sia. You can hear the smaller pop drop in the pop R&B hit We Don't Talk Anymore by Charlie Puth. Don't wanna know the kind of dress you're wearing tonight. If you're holding on to you so tight, the way I did before. I overdosed, should've known your love was a game. Now I can't get you out of my brain. Oh, it's such a shame. We don't talk anymore. We don't talk anymore. The climax. A dance track may have several drops. The climax is typically the biggest drop in the track. Often it's the point at which the big hook melody and lyric is sung along with the foundational dance beat for the final choruses after a big break and buildup. Here's an example of the break, buildup, and climax in Closer by the Chainsmokers.
Shoulder, pull the sheets right off the dress that you stole from your roommate back in Boulder. We ain't ever getting older. We ain't.
Now let's take a look at top-line song structure. Dance and EDM songs share the same song structure as any other current pop, country, urban, or rock hit. You'll recognize verse and chorus sections, pre-chorus and bridge sections. In top-line, though, there's a great deal of emphasis placed on the hook. A hook is an unforgettable, irresistibly catchy phrase in a song. It has to be something listeners just can't get out of their heads. A hook can be a vocal phrase or a song section. In a song, it's often the last line of the chorus, but it may be the entire chorus section or refrain. Here's an example of a repeated hook-style refrain in the hit song, The Middle.
Oh, baby, why don't you just meet me in the middle? I'm losing my mind just a little. So why don't you just meet me in the middle? In the middle.
A hook can be as simple as a wordless vocal phrase. Here's the intro to the urban hit, Friends, by Marshmello and Anne Marie. Now here's the vocal hook again, combined with another hook to create a chorus section.
Haven't I made it obvious? Haven't I made it clear?
A hook can also be created or emphasized electronically, as it is in this song, The Heart Wants What It Wants, recorded by Selena Gomez.
You might be right, but I don't care. There's a million reasons why I should give you up.
But the heart wants what it wants.
The post-chorus. In top-line songs, you're likely to find a section called the post-chorus. The post-chorus is a short section following the chorus that usually consists of a repeated, catchy vocal phrase or instrumental riff, or both. It may be just a few words from the chorus, the title of the song, or a wordless vocal. Not every song has a post-chorus. But when they do, it can be very effective, as it is in this song, New Rules by Dua Lipa.
One, don't pick up the phone. You know he's only calling because he's drunk and alone. Two, don't let him in. You have to kick him out again. Three, don't be his friend. You know you're gonna wake up in his bed in the morning. And if you're under him, you ain't getting over him. I got no rules, I count him.
The track structure will help you identify where you want to put your verse, chorus, hook, or post-chorus. There are no hard and fast rules. You can sing your chorus over a break and your post-chorus over the drop. It's up to you. Now that you know what to look for, check out the top-line songs included in the course. And look for the breaks, build-ups, drops, post-choruses, and hooks.
I got no rules, I count them.